Good morning, my students. I hope you all are taking good care of yourself and I wish you health and happiness always. So let's begin. But before I begin, let me explain a few things today. That this week only, this week I will take as a revision week. From next week, inshallah, we will begin next new lessons. But for this week, I have tried to get all the covered material so far, along with book references and pages on these slides. So things become more clear and easy for both of us, like whatever confusion between notes and book should be resolved through this. So since I am also new and almost half of the syllabus, more than half of our syllabus is covered by the previous teacher, so even then I tried everything to get at one place. So see, this week, okay, so this week I have planned that we will quickly recap the chapter 7 and chapter 8, right? So I have mentioned the pages here. The page is 189 to 320 on your books. So okay, now you get back to your books and start reading through your books. So covered material is total covered material between February and March is chapter 7 to 12. It means 7, 8, 9, 11, 12. Everything is done. Okay, but we we have three classes in a week, so this week I will take two chapters or three chapters in one class, and we will revise the main points. Okay, so like from unit 2 I have taken chapter 7 and chapter 8 for today's class. Okay, and India and China established empires, and chapter 8 is African civilizations. So first I will quickly just revise the terms and the rest you will see in your books. So India's first empire, what we read in this chapter was the Mauryan and Gupta empires in India, and how did the Mauryan empire begin. This was all about in this chapter, and like a few terms we will revise. And that was Mauryan empire. What was Mauryan empire? It was the first empire in India and it was founded by Chandragupta. Then we have Ashoka. Who was Ashoka? He was a grandson of Chandragupta. And he was a leader who brought the Mauryan Empire to its greatest height. And then what is religious here? What is religious toleration? Religious toleration means acceptance of the right of people to have differing religious belief. And then what is Gupta Empire? Gupta Empire is the second empire in India and it is founded by Chandragupta. Okay, so Mauryan Empire was the first and Chandragupta was the second. And then particle, what is particle? Basically, I still remember I had explained it in the class that particle means relating to a social system in which the father is the head of the family. And matrilocal, it is related to a social system in which the mother is the head of the family. Then a little bit we discussed trade, spreads, Indian religion, religions and culture. And in this lesson you have learned how the trade caused changes in Indian religions and culture, and we also had explored the ways in which Indian culture changed and grew between the Mauryan and Gupta empires. So the main terms was like Mahayana. Mahayana is a sect of Buddhism, and Theravada, it's also a sect of Buddhism. This sect talk about the like that offers salvation to all and allows popular worship, and this sect focusing on strict spiritual discipline. And then we have Indian sects, that was Brahma. These are the names of the god that Brahma, who was Brahma. They Indians, like Hindus, believe that he was the creator of the world because they believe in many gods. And then Vishnu. Vishnu was a god that preserves the world. This is what they believe in. And Shiva. Shiva is also a name of god, which Hindus believe that he is the one who will destroy the world. Okay, then Kalidas, it was one of the India's greatest poet and playwriter. And Silk Road, we read about that, caravans, that what is Silk Roads? Basically, caravan routes that crisscrossed Central Asia. Then we read about Han emperors in China, and what we read that, we read about the Han dynasty in China and learned about important rulers of the Han dynasty. Few terms like Han dynasty, you can have its definition that basically what was Han dynasty? It was Chinese dynasty that was ruled from most of the period from 202 BC to AD 220. And we got an idea, like we read the term centralized government. So you should know what is centralized government. Centralized government means that concentrates power in central authority. Then civil services, what are civil services? Administrative departments of a government. Civil services are like a administrative departments of the government, and a word describing government jobs and employees. Monopoly, we often find this word in our lessons, that monopoly means one group complete control over the production and distribution of certain goods. Assimilation, what is assimilation? It's a policy of encouraging conquered peoples to adopt the institutes and and customs of the conquering nation. Then the next chapter was African civilization, and in that we read about the Kingdom of Uksum. So you read about the Kingdom of Uksum and its role in trade, and also discuss the causes and effects of events in Uksum. So Uksum, what was Uksum? Uksum, it's an African kingdom that reaches the height of its power in the 4th century. And Adulis, here, Adulis, he was a chief, it is a chief seaport of Uksum. And then we have Ezena here. Ezena, it's a name of a king of Uksum who conquered Kush. And then we have terraces. It's a term that is used in the lesson, that it's step-like ridges that build on slopes to improve farming. You will find each and everything in detail in your books, and I gave you the reference, but here I'm just giving quick recap of the terms which is used in this lesson. Okay, diverse societies in Africa. So in this lesson, you have learned about African people who developed the societies and the causes and effect of migration in Africa among Bantu-speaking people. So what is Sahara? Sahara is the name of a large desert in Africa. Sahel, it's a land at the southern edge of Sahara. Savannah is a greasy plain. Lineage, what is lineage? It's a group of people descendant from a common ancestor. Stateless societies are the societies without central government. And then we have patrilineage is a tracing ancestry through the father, and matrilineage is a tracing ancestry through the mother. And then we have animism here. I lost my cursor every time. Okay. Animism, it's a religion in which spirits play a role in daily life. And then at the end we have desertification. What is desertification? It's a drying of soil which causes people to move to new land. And then Nok, who are Noks? Noks are basically African people who lived in what is now Nigeria from 500 BC to AD 200. And then almost the second lesson of African civilization was about migration, like the causes and effects of migration in Africa. We just discussed what were the causes and among the Bantu speaking people. So what is basically migration? Migration is a permanent move from one area to another. And then there was a term push-pull factors. Reasons. These are the reasons attracting or driving people to move. And Bantu-speaking people. Who are Bantu-speaking people? People who speak one of a group of languages related to Bantu. Bantu is like a tribe. So people who speak one of the group of languages related to Bantu are called Bantu-speaking people. Then I tried to collect few essential questions, but these are not the only questions. You have much more than that. But I just captured few of them, like who were the iron? When you will go through all these chapters, you will find the answers that who were Iron Age societies, who were the Bantu speaking people, why did the Bantu peoples keep moving to new areas, what are the main reasons for migration, like name three key reasons of migration, what achievements and advances were made in Uksum, what was unique about Uksum's culture, why did the rulers of Uksum move their capital, what changes did Ashoka make in Mauryan Empire, how did the Gupta Empire end, how did Chandragupta hold its a vast empire together. So you, this like in this lesson, we tried to revise main terms and the important questions. You need to look in chapter 8 and 7, 7 and 8. Okay, so here I come again. The most important thing is the task of today. What you have to do, you have to go through these chapters, and you have to prepare the assessment of chapter 7 and 8, and this is between 186 to 225. And you can also have you can also see the assessment at the end of the chapter. So don't let this be you. Plan ahead. Take care. See you again.